So this gets, this guy gets nothing under it. I just laid the units in here.
Okay.
Now, the bottom gets quarter inch stock, quarter inch. So what if, so you take a 3/16 and a 16th. You usually go like there. There. Oh, let me go the other way just because that's the way he always does it.
Okay.
So there and there. Okay. So that's it. So then what you want to do is, what I'm looking at is kind of the reveal.
Right.
You know, making sure the spacer bar is not coming into the zone anywhere. It looks pretty good. Now, what goes around the outside edge is 3/32. Now, it could vary a little bit, right? I mean, there's a 16th variance on everything.
Okay.
But this looks pretty good there.
Yeah.
So what I do is I just get a little pry bar action. I lay this guy in there. I lay that guy in there, and then I come over the other side. Okay, now. That's pretty good. But see, this guy here's got a lot of room. A lot of room. So, and this reveal right here is still really good.
Yeah.
See, we've got an extra 32nd, which is okay, as long as the reveals are good.
Okay.
Okay.
We gotta.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Tell me. No, just saying, so we gotta fill that up. Like you're doing, never in the middle. Right, unless
there's something above it.
Right, okay.
Now, I might do that there, okay? Just sometimes this stuff has bows, it has all sorts of stuff.
Right.
But I'm not putting nothing down here.
Okay.
But I'm just kind of looking at it. This guy here having as much space, what he might do then, you'll have some of them. Get these little guys, right? These are, that's a 60, but these are all 32nds.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So, you know, we can do that, or, usually I'm laying down. If you really wanted to really look at it, right, that 32nd won't barely even go in there all the way down in.
Okay.
You know, I mean, it won't, this one here.
Right.
It just goes into
you're
that guy.
Basically trying to achieve the reveal from both of these two guys right here.
Yeah, I'm just trying to achieve, but if you're gonna put a 32nd in there, you gotta put one in over here.
Right.
And that's fine. It takes a 32nd, so be it. So here we can actually do that, right? We're laid down.
Right. But if it's up, then it's a little bit more quite difficult.
Way more difficult. Yeah. So you just kinda you lay it up, you put down the quarter inch, bang. Then you look at the top, you say, yeah, it's all hidden. Because all we just don't want is just want that spacer bar coming down into the field of view.
Okay.
So let me come up. You know, the glass can be a little small, the opening can be a little bit big.
Do you always want more shims at the bottom than at the top?
Well, at the bottom, if it's really big, then we gotta go with more shims. If it's super, super wide, right? But this isn't super wide. And you know, a glazer too. If you got a glazer there, it's just a feel. It's just really a feel. I mean, there's no, that's what I said. It's, so I go to go 32nd.
We'll have a whole stack of these.
You'll get a bunch of them, in a you know, like a big baggie of them.
Yeah.
You know, like you see here, right? So I got one side going up pretty good. This one's got a little bit of room. This one here's got a little bit of room. That's okay. We are going to tie this all together with silicone, right? Okay, so now we can maybe try to do another 32nd in the bottom of this one. Now the next window may not, right?
It's just
got a little bit of space, right? I'm just gonna fill that.
I mean, so basically, you don't really want it to be like super, super tight with shim, right?
Well, if it does end out, fine.
Oh, it's okay. Okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
Because what you can get is some side jams that are wavy, and you might have to pry it to get it in. You know, you can. The glass is straight.
Okay.
The glass is square. By shimming it pretty close, that means the frame is square.
Right.
So okay. You know, and if it's just got this, just got a little bit of wiggle, totally fine.
Okay.
Totally fine. So now what I'm gonna do is, the hardest part to me is because we have so much space in there, right? You gotta cut all these things off. So these ones are like 16ths, and so when I'm gonna put them back in his box, I just wanna make sure that that can be on the floor, doesn't it?
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I mean, like that guy there, he's done. He's too small,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So these are all 3/32, but down below, these are all
16ths.
Yeah. Cut them off flush.
You gotta push it all the way through till you hit the stop?
Yep.
Yep.
Push it all the way in underneath until you hit the stop. Because you want both pieces of glass to ride on that block.
Right.
So now we're gonna break open that bundle right there. That one, yep. Four of those little guys.
Okay.
Those two? Okay. Now, oh, I didn't cut one off here. That's all right. Okay.
This one.
Oh, those are the two I just put in, huh?
Yep.
Okay, so these, don't quote me, but in theory, are cut the length. And what it is, you'll see, it's about a 3/16 short. Okay, so what we're gonna do is it's just we're gonna leave it about 8 or so on each side, right? So we wanna cut the gasket. Straight. About 1/8 of an inch. So it butts right there. Okay. So that one's just like that.
Yeah.
We'll cut this one. About 1/8.
There's a top and a bottom? Is it,
what do you mean by that?
Is that like these things, or is it, does it matter like it's a top or?
The gasket goes against the glass.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
Part goes, okay.
Yeah, and this guy goes just like this and like this. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna silicone. So these get silicone three sides. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is this gets, we're gonna silicone like from about here all the way around to about there.
Okay.
Okay. And then it starts getting this little touchy feely area. What I mean by that is it's just all about feel. So you wanna, you're kinda just I picked my gun's bad.
I know, it's not key to have a good one, yeah.
Well, no, it's full of silicone. I did. This is the one I was going to clean out.
Oh.
Okay. you guys will get this. Now what we do, you just kind of give it a little bit of a oof. Just like, just a little bit of a oof.
Down and up.
About a 5-10 degree angle. Okay. And you just go in, a little bit into the wood. Every 8 inches. See here, just, you see I'm pushing that down just a little bit. A little bit of an angle, the screw will pull it down. Under the wood a little bit. We'll do this one too.
So the drill bit's not coming with the package, or?
It can, it's just an 1/8 inch drill bit.
Okay.
These will be in there. The screw heads can break off. You'll feel it bite, and just grab, and then you're done. If a screw head breaks, drill right next to it. That's it, yep. Because they're stainless.
Yeah, right.
If one breaks and it's kind of sticking far out.
It doesn't matter. It can stick way out. The metal's going to go over this. Okay. It's okay.
Okay.
Now remember when you're vertically glazing, you'll set this down on its blocks. One guy's holding the glass. Kind of block up the sides, you take a look at it, you go up and you halt, you set that guy there, screw it, the guy can let go of the glass,
right? Okay.
Right? It's held in place.
Right, right, right,
that's
right.
All you need a second guy for.
Okay.
Okay? If you were doing this vertically, everything would just be falling down. So now what we do is, there's two things. Right now what I would do is, these plastic clips will come in the box. You'll see that there's a spacer little side there, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
You see that little guy that goes against the glass. We usually go about like that. Okay, fix the spacer on this guy. You're right.
Okay.
When I blew this off, I blew this shim apart. Oh, a couple inches, inch and a half from the end.
Okay.
This is probably just gonna kind of skewies one more in there just because it's just kind of off size. And I think we have a little spec that shows like every 8 inches, every 10 inches. This one here is kind of a push. You want to keep it flat. You want to give it a little bit of down pressure. You're going to drill it right in the middle. me, from down on, you know, and I'm doing it like this, way easier.
Way easier, right, right.
Yeah.
You don't need to put a beat up or anything behind that.
No.
Okay.
The bottom of this is made to drain out. No silicone here.
Right.
Just gotta find this little hole. See, yeah. When I'm, because I'm blind now, right? If you're the other way, you wouldn't be blind.
Right.
Yeah. I'm down, you can see it, yeah.
Yep, you can see it.
And if you break a screw, just move it over and...
Yep.
Yep.
Just move it over a quarter of an inch. You did bring your plug in with you?
No,
I have my mic.
Okay. So, oh, you know, this piece is gonna go on there like that, okay? And this piece is gonna go on here like this. But one thing you gotta watch out for every once in a while is this metal just overhangs a little bit. Because when I cut this to length, I'm gonna be cutting it from metal to metal. So when it goes in, one side might be, the wood might be sticking out of here. Just okay. Kind of be aware.
Okay.
And I as we go through it, I'll show you. I mean, I... Make sure some of these end cuts are decent.
So what would we... Will be doing to the field too, is cutting these? Or?
Yep.
Okay.
I'll just go cut it. Here. See how this? See the rake of the blade? It's a zero rake, so the blade has no hook.
Right.
And that really helps with aluminum.
Okay.
Right?
We should be okay.
So now, this is the part that's always really, really fun. He does it right, like. Hear it click?
Yeah.
Didn't click all the way in though. Try it on this one here. Sometimes it goes click, 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 click. So what you want to do is you get it down there and you get it on one end, right? Click. Take a small piece of wood and tap it, because it looks like right here it might not be quite in, but I think it is. Yeah, it looks like it's in.
Yeah.
Sometimes it goes click, 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 click. You can hear it snap. So what he's saying is the clip is like right there. If you didn't think it was in, right?
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah. So what if you're proud?
What do you mean?
Like this guy's a little proud. It usually won't be.
It can be. It's this there. It varies, right? It's just it's exactly. Not exact. It's not 100. How hard did I push that clip in?
Right.
Right. It's all about that clip.
Okay.
And the reason why the corner windows are so hard to cut is, see how this guy doesn't lay flat? It's a double compound miter for the corners.
Right.
And that's
what
the glazers struggle with, and it varies. But you're gonna see, because I'm gonna cut this piece of metal right here. We're gonna put that in, and then we're gonna put this in, and then we've got two compound miters to put these in.
Right.
Okay.
We got a dish carpenter.
This is 15.5. This is 17.5.
Okay.
Right?
Yep.
17.5, 15.5.
Yep.
So what we do is we cut all the tops at 15.5, then you come back at 17.5, you cut that one.
Okay.
So what we got to do now is we got to put the top piece on, this piece. So, we just go here. Let me go the other way. Let me go. It doesn't matter. It's just a straight cut, right?
Right.
Guy here, you want to get the bottom to go in. It's kind of a slide up.
Got it.
Uh-oh, what did I do there? Dog. I just take it right back off. See, that's where the wood's longer, right?
Right.
Okay, let me get this just to click in. You got him over? Yeah. Okay. It's just weird. Sometimes it goes click, click, click.
Right.
Sometimes it don't. As you can see, it's about, you know, half inch short in the metal. So what we're going to do is we're going to go about a quarter of an inch. You're going to cut a little 30 degree angle. Then it kind of lays onto that gasket just like that up there. See that?
Wow.
Okay. And then what you're going to do is you're going to cut this guy straight. Now my angle's not so good down here, but that's still okay. Normally, because what I did is I cut a little bit too much of an angle, but it's fine. It's all laying on each other. The one up there looks really good, so we're gonna go to the next one. We cut him about a quarter inch long. Lay it on there, you take a look, it looks just like that. You wanna cut this rubber to the end of this metal. Okay, so let me get around you here. I gotta get straight on with it here. So what I do is I just take it. Come on, baby. Yeah. You can see that the metal, you can see it's just a hair long, but that's okay, because it's not gonna hurt nothing. See how it's just kind of bubbling up right there a little bit? Because remember now, it all hides, right?
Because it's scooping up a little bit.
Oh, okay.
And that's just fine.
Right.
That doesn't hurt a thing. I don't like my cut up there as much. I'm going to give it a little bit more of an angle. Just so it just kind of lays out, and that'll be just fine.
Got it.
Right? Okay, so now we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna drill three, right? If you like it. So what I do is I push down. We'll get it. The whole thing. 17. Okay, 15 and 5, right? Okay, so what I do, it's kind of weird. This is really kind of a weird, it's a feel, because this guy is actually gonna sit down a hair lower than this and a hair lower than this.
Okay.
So even when you think you got it perfectly cut, it's really, it's kind of not.
Yeah.
It'll be a little long.
Yeah.
And Mike's really good at that. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna tell you that my pencil's not that good, but I'm right about there. I'll do this one. And that one. So we said 17, right? Okay, so I'm gonna cut it upside down.
Fine.
Looks fine.
Yeah.
Yep. So this guy's actually sticking up. I'm wondering if let me just make sure this guy's in. Yep. Yep. Yeah. And that's, I mean, they'll do that, right? They'll be a little up, a little down. You know what? It doesn't feel like it's in. Let me see. So remember about being able to take these guys off?
So simple.
Yeah, it's a pop, right? Pop and it's off.
Hmm.
Believe me, they stay on.
Yeah, so these ones are not too bad. You can kind of get your hands around it.
Yep.
I think these ones, yeah.
Okay. I'll tell you what Mike's gonna tell me to do. He's gonna tell me to take that guy off and push it down. We'll see, right? We'll see what the pro says. Hey Mike, tell me what to do right here. Right there.
Pop that guy off, pull your screw out, and push the thing down.
Okay?
Yeah, I'll metal.
Yep, no, I will. That's why I thought exactly what you tell me.
But,
it doesn't it, feel
it's,
like
it's
this
not. You don't have to push down a lot.
Yeah.
And you just sneak a putty knife. Gotcha. In there.
Right, right.
See that?
Yeah.
So let me get this right here. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because look how just gotta sneak it in.
It really didn't look like it went down, did it? But it must
have. The worst that's gonna happen. Like the black part on it that they see. You know, you'll have to just touch it up with a Sharpie or paint or whatever.
Right.
Works. Exactly. Then they don't really see it.
Is it up on that end too?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. You can see how this gasket is compressed a little bit more than that. See how I can do that.
Right.
And firstly, if you put it down too tight, you'll notice that this is hard to get off.
Yep.
You can usually carefully tap it off.
Okay.
If you hit it too hard, it's going to bend a little bit. If it's a long one, you can kind of massage it out.
Yeah, so this guy,
and if it's too loose, right, if you put it on and it doesn't feel like it's going on, you know, you kind of flick with your putty knife and see, okay, is that baby going to come off and
land?
And
it's
on.
And it's down, right?
Yeah. Already. Try to repair it, but I put this guy in and I can. So I'm not able to squeeze it this way.
The way they go.
See here, look at these cuts. Those are 17.
Yeah. Yep. See, you see how this dove down a little bit more? That mean that your clip it. Could be kicked this way a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yep.
And it takes a while. You know, that thing's always trying to walk on you when you
Right, right.
When you hold it in.
Right. So.
I could take these off, and I could just cut this at like 18 and a half degrees.
Oh, that's really close, dude.
That's really, really close. Way better, huh? That looks way better.
Oh, yeah, it looks titties.
Yeah. Yeah. That's gonna be just fine. So you get the bottom to kind of go in first. Nope. Once it just kind of grabs that little spot.
There you go.
That's it.
Nice.
That looks way better.
Nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's the whole deal.